Hello friends, so this video is all about the journey of APIS. As many of you had requested for the PPT, so I thought might as well present it in a more systematic manner on this platform of YouTube and Zoom. So that's how, let me share the screen and we will do the entire journey of APIS in a very systematic format. Like the case was presented already. So I'm not going to talk about the case here. I'm just going to talk about in general APIS mellifica, how to understand this. So here it goes, our masters, Dr. Milind Rao sir and Dr. Ashok Mahanty sir, because of whom I got such refreshing and a deep insight in homeopathy, and I actually started falling in love with the science only because of their love for their students and the science. They made it so easy for us in their happy-going and very enthusiastic, friendly manners. They taught us homeopathy, like how a child is taught to hold a pencil and then draw something and then see how you can erase it. So the child is so interested in doing it. See, you can draw a circle and then you can erase with the eraser, and see, you can draw a square. So with little bits and pieces of information, they taught us how to join these dots, how to connect, and how to prescribe remedies right from scratch. You know, initially, when the initial days of my experience in Sir's clinic, in Rao Sir's clinic, he just showed me belladonna patients in the first week. And then first day also I'm seeing only belladonna, second day also I'm only understanding belladonna, third day also he's teaching me only belladonna. So I was like, yeah, he's only teaching me belladonna. And then you won't believe, the next week when there was a patient, it was a new case, and he asked me, ki Pallavi, tell me, what will you give her? I told her, sir, this is very simple, light desire, frivolous carry desire, it is belladonna, sir. Sir was so happy. Wow, you have learned to prescribe a remedy. I was like, oh, it was such a big achievement. And really, they taught us so easily. We would not even realize that we have learned it all. We would just think, yeah, chalte firte ho gaya, you know. It was like cupcakes, small cupcakes. You just keep eating and you keep enjoying. So we have just enjoyed homeopathy with them. And that's how we have enjoyed our lives in, with them. And we will continue to enjoy. So I owe this remedy also to them, because it was Mohanty sir who actually first introduced this remedy in my memory, in my mind. Let's imbibe the noble teachings of our gurus and rejuvenate the society with the elixir of compassion and everlasting unity along with homeopathy. Just give me a minute. Here it goes.
I hope the voice is clearer now. Okay. So the journey of APIS mellifica, where the life cycle of honeybee, how it goes, we will see that. The honeybee comb we all have seen, you know, they are of different sizes. Some are small, some are big. And after a few days, you say they keep growing longer and longer, wider and wider. And what happens inside that? Inside every honeybee comb, there are three types of honeybees. One is a male honeybee, the king, the drone, male drone, the queen bee, the female honeybee. And there are a lot of multiple worker bees. Okay. Now, this male honeybee, and the queen bee, they unite and lot of eggs are released. The male honeybee dies after this, and the queen bee also dies after all these eggs are released. And now where are these eggs stored? In the comb, these worker bees, they work round the clock and they build these, make these small pockets, okay, inside which an egg is stored. And those 200, 300 eggs are laid at one go in one copulation, and they are stored in these pockets. These pockets are made by the worker bees, and they are composed of the wax that they when the worker bees, they go on a flower, they pollination also takes place through the honeybees. So when they are on the flower, they take the nectar, the extract the nectar from the flower, and when they come inside their comb, they keep on chewing that nectar, and that is how they form the wax. They release that wax and they form these small pockets, and inside these pockets, these eggs, they hatch, they become larva, they grow into a pupa, and then they become adult bees. And these adult bees, so that's how they keep multiplying. So many honeybees are formed. So as we see in this stage, so basically most of the honeybees are of this worker bee category. Okay, they are the worker types. Now, how do they work? They are very, very fanciful. Okay, the way these worker bees, when they see a nectar is very close by to their comb, they will come in a dancing fashion in two varieties. They come in a particular manner when they know, and a slow speed and a particular design, like a circular design, when they know that the nectar is close by. And when they go and find out that the nectar is very far off, so they come in that infinity design pattern and they dance very swiftly and in a faster manner. So the other worker bees, they get an indication that the nectar is close by or nectar is far off. And they do it in a very fancy way. So this is the approach of Apis. Throughout the journey of Apis, you will see an affability. In affability, there is friendliness. The person does not complain in friendliness. When somebody is friendly to you, they are not complaining. They are not raising their voice. They are very gentle to you. So even though they have any problem, they do not exhibit their problems, or they exhibit in a manner that others don't get hurt, or others don't get so much affected. So their approach is affable. Activity desires, dancing, industrious, ardent, vivacious. Now, what is dancing? We understood that they enjoy what they are doing. It is not that it is a burden for them to do anything for the eggs or for their comb or for their people. It is, they do it as if they enjoy it. And industrious, they are just continuously buzzing all the time. And they are ardently doing. Ardent is, again, we have done this in the earlier lectures also, that ardent is when the person gives his best. It is at intellectual level, that whatever they know about it, they will just give it their all. And vivacious and cheerful perspiration during shows that perspiration is how much a person is working hard. And when after working hard the entire day, the person perspires, and that gives a sense of satisfaction that I did so much for my family, or I did so much for my loved ones. So they feel very happy about it. Antics playing. Antics is what? Antics indicates that they just need a little bit of attention in whatever way they are doing. And they are doing it in a very lively manner, a playful manner. And in that, they need only little attention of yours, that you just say that, wow, you're looking nice, you're doing so well. That's it. Okay, they want to grab your attention for some time so that, you know, you appreciate them. Okay, acknowledge them. Delusion enlarged. So delusion large and delusion enlarged. means from overall they are enlarged, overall they have that potential to do it. Pregnant she is, so they can do it, they have the potential, they have all the energies and they know how to do it, they will give their best. Delusion, he walks on cotton. In spite of being so industrious and doing it all, they walk on cotton. Cotton is something which is very easy to do. Cotton is something by which you don't get hurt. So they do it in such a swift manner that they feel it is very fine for me. I can just do it all. You tell me this is to be done, that is to be done. Everything they will just do. Delusion, he is well. So here they don't feel any problem in doing. Others are thinking that, oh, he's such a hardworking person. But they feel it's all well. Company desire for alone when aggravates. So they are social people. They want people around them. And they want to be with people. From where problem begins in such a lively and dancing, playful person, problem begins with ailments from anger, rage, fury. So any experience in their life which brings on rage, which brings on that anger, brings problem to Apis, because they don't like to be so. Okay, they don't like, they want to be affable, they want to be cheerful. Ailments from anticipation, when something they have to anticipate, now what, how is this going to happen? Huh? They want to do everything swiftly, but when things don't work out so swiftly, there is anticipation. Ailments from celibacy, ailments from disappointment, something they expected from their own people, it is not from the world. It is from their own close people that they expect little bit. So that's what antics play. I was trying to explain that they expect little of your acknowledgement, little of your attention, and something which is very naturally expected out of you for the hard work that they are doing, for the kind of emotional drainage that is taking place from them, and even physically they are draining. Emotional excitement, ailments from emotional excitement, ailments from fright, jealousy, mental shock. Now, mental shock is not just a little bit of anything. Mental shock comes as a very big blow to the person, that it is not just a small breakup, that, you know, I met this boy, I liked him, we were in relation for a month or so, and then we had a breakup. No, that is not mental shock. Mental shock is something very tremendous, where you believed the person a lot, you given your whole and soul to the person, you had a lot of trust in that person, and then it comes as a big blow to you that he has ruined you financially, emotionally, mentally, and you are left with nothing in your hand. At the last minute, he will fall off, or he will have some another affair, or he will just ditch you in some situation where it is very difficult for you to come out. So that is mental shock, ailments from sexual excesses. Then comes excitement. Excitement in Apis after bad news. Excitement heat during. Excitement in hydrocephalus. So Apis, we all know, is a remedy for edema, body edema, pitting edema, okay, red hot edematous conditions. So in hydrocephalus, where there is edema of the head, of the intellectual faculty, edema takes place when you take in a lot of bad vibes, where there is a lot of collection of things which are not good for your body. You should just secrete them, but they are not going out. They withheld every, that is why Apis is very close to Natramur, because Natramur also has a tendency to keep things which have hurt them. Apis will keep everything, they will absorb the shock inside and they will keep suffering then. Delivery after meaning, suppose a lady who's just been working, she's a working woman, and suppose husband is somewhere out or he's sick or something, and this lady has to take up the charge of the family, and she's been doing round the clock, she's been working. She was pregnant also, she didn't take a break. She's just working, that, you know, after my pregnancy, after delivery, I will get reciprocation. I will get somebody who will take care of me. After my delivery, they will be there around me and I will be free of all this. But after delivery, what happens? There is no reciprocation. She has to still keep on doing and keep on slogging. So the problems begin after delivery. As we saw in the first stage, she was pregnant. And year after delivery, the pregnant, the problems have not resolved, but they have only multiplied. Sensitive to steel pointed things, steel points directed towards her. So just imagine you have been slogging the entire day. You gave it your all and still what people are saying, you could not even do this. You didn't know how to do this. You just leave it. It's not your cup of tea. So these are steel points directed. She feels that, you know, and she gets very sensitive to little criticism that comes from others. So those are steel points which are directed towards her, that you are like this. They're poking her. Nursed children in being desire to only in the daytime. So those children whose mothers have gone through a lot, and when they deliver this child, the feeling is transferred from mother to child psychodynamically. And that's how the child also reflects the same kind of feeling, that in the daytime when I have slogged and I have worked hard so much, I want somebody to nurse me, somebody to take care of me, nourish me. Okay, I will work, but then you nourish me and I will work. Okay, but there is nobody to do that. And why only in the daytime? Because daytime only he is working hard. In the nighttime, he will manage, because in the nighttime, everybody sleeps. And in the nighttime, I want that me time to wipe my tears and to express myself in my own ways. I don't want to disturb anybody. I will keep those emotions to myself. In the nighttime, people are not watching me. So it doesn't matter whether you nurse me or not. So this could be an interpretation. I have not applied it clinically. But this nursing desire was there. Okay, now if you see psychodynamically that I was saying, now these are emotional typograms, where if there is love, then how there is lightening up inside the body. When there is depression, there is inhibition inside the body. Anxiety brings up stimulation in the chest area. Contempt brings about negativity throughout the body and overstimulation in the head area. Pride calls off for stimulation in the head and chest area again. Shame is bringing stimulation in the eyes. So this is emotional typology, which is nowadays being studied by Europeans. And there is a book also on it. You can just search for it. And now you see at three physical level rubrics are there in the mind section of the repertory, where they have mentioned anxiety, cough from. So cough is again what? Cough is something that a person wants to say something, but he's not able to. Maybe the environment is not receptive to it, or the person feels that I don't want to tell them. But I want them to understand me, but they are not receptive. And still I want to speak up, but he holds it to himself. So anxiety, cough from, something will burst. Now, what is this something? What will burst? He has that anxiety that this cough is there and it should go. Otherwise, this feeling will come out. Fear, cough from, something will burst. Restlessness, respiration difficult with. Now, what is this problem? He's getting restless with the problem, and respiration is difficult with, meaning where the exchange of ideas. Respiration is what? Breathing is just taking in air and giving out. Respiration is where there is exchange at the level of alveoli, where oxygen is taken up, carbon dioxide is released. So that is the process of respiration, where exchange of ideas at a deeper level is very, very difficult. Okay. Fever, anxiety, fever, excitement, nervous fever, indifference fever, aphasia with typhoid-like fever. Again, talking about it is difficult. It is just lingering. It is going at a very dull pace. Menses, dullness children in at puberty in girls. Now, dullness in children. Okay. Those And puberty girls are, what is this puberty girls? Puberty girls are those girls, you know, where they are seeing those bodily changes coming in their body, and they look forward for those changes, and they see those elder girls, that how they have matured. Oh, I am also developing those features, and they want to take selfies, they want to grow hair, they want to put those nail paints, and they want to shape their nails, and they just admire the body shape that they're transforming into. But the epis puberty girl would be how? Dullness in children. These children of epis, they lack that sharpness, they lack that swiftness, you know, they become dull in their way of living, because they have seen it all and they have been through it all. So that is how their appearance would be dull. There are those girls, even in mostly in low strata, low economic strata, you will see those girls who have no keenness in growing up or flaring their or exhibiting their features. They are so dulled by seeing how their life has been. So this is the kind of state of epis, dullness children in puberty girls. Delirium menses during menstrual difficulties with. So menses again is what menses again signifies a failure. Menses is something where pregnancy was expected and it did not happen. So menstrual difficulties will be at regular interval menstruation happens. Something which is very periodic and something which happens. But every time there is a disappointment, whenever something was about to happen and the person feels disappointed. So delirium menses, menstrual difficulties with confusion of mind, suppressed menses from. So something which should have happened has not been allowed to happen. So that leads to confusion of mind. Where am I going wrong? I am doing everything that possibly I could do, but still I'm not getting things. I'm not getting the love. I'm not getting what I should be getting. Now, what state comes is delusion cannot walk. Earlier, he was walking on cotton. And now they feel that, you know, I cannot walk. Delusion, he must run or hop. Because there is disappointment, because of the mental shock, epis becomes more alert about things. And then they forget resting, they forget to go at a pace, they just run or must hop. So when you are running or hopping, your feet are not on the ground for a longer time. They are just 1 foot at a time. You are just putting 1 foot at a time. So you're not resting. You are becoming more and more industrious. Your apoplexy. So when apoplexy happens, entire body functioning goes for a toss. So they fear that my functioning should not go down. Here he has organic heart disease. So heart disease again relating to love, the feeling of love. Fear of being poisoned. Anger violent. Anger striking his head against wall and things. Now what are things again? See, every time things come up. Striking his head. So he's not removing his anger on others. He's removing his anger on himself striking wall against wall and things. Weeping, desire to and ameliorate. So weeping epis is something which is very commonly there, but we miss out prescribing all. Okay, weeping causeless, weeping at everything. Delirium anxious, loquacious, indistinct. They are not distinctly defining what is their trouble, because they don't want to trouble others, or because they feel they don't understand. Maniacal, congestion with. Checking family matters. As we understood that, they become more alert. So their constant worry will be, is their family safe? Is this done? Is that work done? Is the door locked? Is the gas knob closed? So that fear is there, you know. Fear is making them check family matters. Is everybody safe? Are you doing well? So this is how they become very practical. And that is why epis is mentioned in the rubric practical. they become ambition increased competitive. I had to add these two rubrics here and I have missed out on adding. So you please remember, in practical, they become practical. They were not practical, but because of the experiences, they become very practical. That if it is there, it is there. If it is not there, it is not there. It is not going to affect me anymore. So if I'm going to get married to this guy, it's fine. If he's not interested in me, you better tell me now. You don't ditch me later. So this is how they will check family matters. They will be very practical and they become competitive, ambition increased, competitive. They are just wanting to succeed and excel and they become competitive in that. They engross themselves in the work all the more. So busy fruitlessly, anxiety family about his anxiety, chill during chill is again a state of lack of emotions. Now, if you see that movie where Hrithik Roshan was there and he was constantly working and his friends Farhan Akhtar and Bobby Deol telling him, let's go for an outing. I'm going to get married. So he's telling, no, I have meetings to attend. So that is how much he has engrossed. And the reason we come to know that he has seen a lot of poverty and he has undergone a lot of tough times. And then when he finds nectar in Katrina Kaif, and then he wants to just settle down and just slow down his pace. So that is what Epis wants. He wants nectar. He wants that sweetness. He wants that somebody to should love him, to be there, nurse him when he's in his daytime and his productive time. So this anxiety about his family and busy fruitlessly, dictatorial, they become dictatorial in the process. They become censorious in the process, otherwise being very sweet. Closing eyes aggravate. So they cannot close their eyes because if they close their eyes, then anything might happen. Anything that he has faced, the fright, the disappointment, the shocks, his family should not face or he should not face again. So closing eyes, he cannot do that. He has to keep checking. Delusion bed, someone in the bed, as if someone is in bed with him, a strange boy. Boy is an immature person. And this immature, strange person, and how can he just enter in my comfort zone and ruin my sleep and my time of relaxation? So he cannot do that. But he feels constantly threatened. Delusion as if in a fright on waking, that something has happened and he wakes with a fright. So that is why they lose on their sleep time also. Anxiety sleep starting from as if on waking. So they just started in sleep and they just feel that, oh, something has happened or what. And then delusion, specters, ghosts, spirits, vision has on closing eyes. So those frightful images surround them when they close their eyes. And that is the aggravation. Irritability when questioned. And then when people question him that, what happened to you? Why don't you just do this, do that? You know, get married, settle down. They don't want. Why don't you get married? Why see this picture? See that picture? I don't want to get married. Can't you understand? Irritability sends the doctor home when he's very sick. So even though he's sick, even though he needs support, even though he needs somebody to take care of them, he gets irritated. He just says, go back. I'm just doing fine. Just see a picture, mother telling her son, just see this picture, such a nice girl, get married to. I told you I don't want to. So she's telling her, you are aging, this is the right time. No, I don't want to. Now, coming to awkward drops things, which Epis is very famous for, like walking and they tremble upon things. So what is this? Walking, what is awkward drops thing? Like when we were young, we were taught, things are of two types, living things and non-living things. And after that, we did not think about those things. But then this word things is used multiple times in our repertory. So long back when I had prescribed some remedy to somebody, rest cannot until things are in proper place. So I used to think that what are things, you know, what is not in proper place? Then gradually understood that they could be relationships also. When I was taking up arsenic for a lecture and I was preparing and I was listening to this lady who was constantly saying that I want all the relations to be in a good state. If I have a quarrel with anybody or if there is a misunderstanding, before sleeping, I will make it a point that we clear out on those matters. So that is rest cannot until things are in proper place. So what is things, you know? Things are not only non-living things, that aqua drops things. So he drop a cup or he drop a plate or he drop a hat or he drop a umbrella. No, not that. It could be that. But to lead a person to that level, to that state where non-living things are also dropping, it first comes at a more dynamic level, at a more personal, emotional level, where a person feels what are things that, you know, suppose my mom calls up and says, what are you doing, Pallavi? I say, Mama, I will speak to you later. I'm just doing something. What am I doing? I'm taking a lecture, or maybe I'm eating my food. So that thing becomes eating. That thing becomes talking. Now, so suppose my husband comes from work and I ask him, why are you looking so exhausted? What happened? Oh, something went wrong in the office today. So that thing could be a quarrel with the boss. That thing could be anything, you know. So it could be an event. It could be a performance. How was your performance today, my dear? It was not a good affair, good thing to happen. What was not a good thing to happen? My performance was not a good thing to happen, Mama. The mic was not working or whatever. So that thing could be a circumstance, a state of affairs. It could be anything, a thought. I'm thinking something, a thought. So like we say 10 things to do when you are on the mountain. You can do hiking, you can do jumping, you can do climbing, you can do walking. So those are things. Five good things to do on a vacation with children. So gardening or playing. So those are all things. So in Epis, what happens? You know, awkward drops things. So awkwardly, they drop those things. They just drop it. The girl will say, I want to get divorced. And people around are shocked. We all have come here for a party and you are saying that you want to get divorced. So what is this? You know, you could have explained in a proper way or told at the right time, but they just say it awkwardly. Break things. So this is again things where they break the bonds, they break the performance, they don't want to do it, they break that entire chain of thoughts that I just want to cut off. I don't want to stay with this person anymore. I don't want to continue in this job anymore. They will just awkwardly drop things and break things. So at a more psychic level, at a more dynamic level, this is how we can understand it. And then to relating to themselves, they are frivolous, they are a fable, they don't take care of their health. Delusion tongue is made of wood. Now what is wood? Wood is a bad conductor of heat and electricity. We all know that. So when the tongue is made of wood, tongue is something which helps us to speak about ourselves, our emotions, our thought processes, our viewpoints. When we take a lecture or when we talk to our children or when we are talking with our relatives, everything we are expressing through the tongue. But in Epis, that expression is not a swift affair. It doesn't happen very naturally. Tongue is made of wood indicates that it is inflexible. It doesn't speak what is there inside. And that is why edema takes place. Eating refuses to eat. Dr. Milind Rao sir had taken eating refuses to eat. Now, what is eating? Eating is when you nourish yourself. And that is for what? That is for living. It is a survival instinct. What eating is a survival instinct. Like food, clothing, shelter. All these are survival instincts. So when a person refuses to eat, that means he's refusing to survive in that environment. Indifference to agreeable things, like you get married, no. You have a child, I don't want to have a child. So these are all agreeable things. You eat food, no, I don't want to eat food. Something which is agreeable, something which is supporting your life, you don't want to do it, or you are indifferent to it. So when are you all planning a baby? It's been 5 years of marriage. Is it? Is it so important? Indifference to joy of others, indifference, joyless. Delirium declares well she is. So that delirium declare well she is could be at pathological level also, where people are telling him, why don't you see a doctor? You have been having this kind of blood pressure since so long. It is not affecting me. Just stop talking about it. I'm all right. Don't ask me again and again. These sentences will come out. laughing at misfortune. It is not the misfortune of others, but her own misfortune. Laughing over serious matters. So they just show as if they are so happy in life, although they are feeling so miserable inside. Mirth simulating hilarity while he feels wretched. And this was the state which Mohanty sir had shown us in multiple cases. Like a knee joint was highly inflamed and there was so much of swelling, the person was not able to stand also, and he's just laughing and saying, "Ha, doctor, I have got this swelling. See, I can't even walk." So doctor is like, "What is there to laugh in this? You're feeling miserable that you can't even walk." And that is where he had taught us Epis. Once a case was there, and the patient was not getting well with any medicine for 6 months. And still he was asking doctor, doctor, how are you? I'm all well. So how's life going? So sir was like, "Hey, how can he be so chill about not getting well and still ask me that, how am I?" So that is where he got affability, and then he taught us about it. So I hope this kind of explanation and journey of Epis, I really owe it to him. And I hope he should be happy about it. And I just hope that you all are able to apply it in your clinics and practice successfully. Mania insanity from suppressed sexual desire. So sexual desire is your sexuality. Your sexuality is your being. You are female, you are male. If I am a female, then where do I stand and how people recognize me is my sexuality. Now somebody's sexual desire, that I wanted to achieve that, you know, I wanted to be there, but it did not happen and it was not allowed to happen. Then it leads to mania and insanity from suppressed sexual desire. Jesting aversion to me. He cannot jest. Obstinate declares there's nothing the matter with him. I told you there is nothing. Just leave it. Stop talking about it. This is how. And this is what sounds shrieking, piercing to others. That how can he be so piercing? This is piercing. People around don't like to listen to this kind of tone of his own person, of his own family member, that why is he talking to us like this? They can't get it because he's not expressing and because others are also not receptive. So for others, it sounds as if it's a piercing noise. Death desires foreknown. Delusion dead, he himself was. Death presentiment of sensation of thoughts of without fear. Now what is death? So desire for death is death of all desires. He just wants to break things, he told. He wants to drop things, he told. Dead is again a break of relation. It's the end of relationship. It is the end of this job in this office. It is the end of my journey from year to year. So it is not death per se. It could be death of that limited space of the experience that he has had. And he just wants to end it there now. Well says he is when very sick. I am all right. I'm just fine. Don't worry about me. But end it all. Will contradiction of. So his will does not know what he has to do with dullness in the head. There is willingness. But that willingness and the dullness in the head, they are not going hand in hand. There is dullness in the head. Control over his will he does not have. The willingness is there, but to exhibit it, there is dullness in the head. So that's the combination of Epis. And this rubric is just summarizing it all. That he does not have control over his will. He does not know what he has to do. And dullness at intellectual level, at head level. That I cannot think beyond this. Just let it be and stay here only. So stupor interrupted by screaming. So there is a phase where he is silent and suddenly there is a sharp sound. But that sound is not perceivable to others. That what does he mean exactly? George Vitalkis has said many things about Epis, which you all can also read from his Materia Medica. I will just highlight the key points in this and you can read the entire thing. Now, what the main purpose motto of this entire lecture was to understand the stages of epis where we are not able to catch. Epis is a large remedy that has been partially understood, little used because of lack of appreciation of the inner nature of the remedy. Kent probably felt similarly when he said in his lecture on epis, we must be able to see in the general beginning of provings the disease which they resemble, for we do not always see the remedy in the advanced stage. We see the disease. So the pathology of epis that we have seen or which happen at the later stage, we can avoid those pathologies to happen if we catch epis in the beginning itself. We see the disease in a state of progress and must be able to see it in the beginning. As was the disease in the beginning, so is the remedy in the beginning. Things that have similar beginnings may have similar endings. It is the subtle changes in the behavior of people in the beginning of illness that most of the time foretell and determine pathological changes in the end. To be able to code these subtle changes is the main objective of materia medica. The edema of epis, aggravated by heat and touch, that you don't come near me, you don't approach me, you don't ask me, you don't make me emotional, is what epis says. So that is what it means. Strong emotions are retained. Intense emotions are not easily expressed. Passion and intensity is there, even at sexual sphere. But they are awkward in expressing their feelings. And they hide their emotions, and there is a pent up of emotion and extreme sexual fervor it is expressed at. They cannot find deep release. And that is how it leads to nymphomania in some cases. They attach impulsively to the nectar whenever they find that there's a sweet person, and they attach impulsively and they tell everything about their life, and then they feel that they are so much attached to it. And then when that person goes away suddenly, then there is another era of emotions. It attacks with blind passion. It attacks the nectar as well as the intruder who comes between him and his loved one. He will attack that. That's the sting of epis. They cannot detach themselves from the honey once they have found it. So it could be, it is not a question of immorality, rather of passion. It is not that the wife is immoral if she's having an extramarital affair, but she shares that equal amount of love between her and her husband. Between him, the other person, and her husband. It is too appealing to her sexually. She continues to respect her husband and does not want to break up her marriage. She can enjoy both her husband and the lover at the same time. This story may quite be common in Mediterranean countries, and this is the result of pathology in epis. We must understand that what happens because of inability to express their emotion, the erotic needs are not expressed in a natural and comfortable manner. They are constantly busy, working, laborers in pursuit of the nectar as if it were a great pleasure to do so. It is significant perhaps that we prescribe this remedy mainly for two mental conditions, busy insanity and erotic insanity. Ovarian cyst manifests in these epis cases very often. They are sexually frustrated women and they develop cyst in a very short time. And it is proportionate to the frustration of the woman's sexual demands. Relationship is found between stress involving sexual frustration for a long time. There is jealousy. Then there is pericarditis, weakened heart, bronchitis. That is what they are saying, psychodynamics, and in different language. Although this theory may seem a gross simplification of complicated, highly sophisticated biological processes which take place in the human organism, you will nevertheless often perceive such a connection in your cases if you look deeply into the real dynamic causation of each case. Such perception requires that we evaluate each case on a level far deeper than that of gross pathology. So the epis jealousy, Lachesis jealousy. So in Lachesis jealousy, the Lachesis person is feeling so much tormented and suspicious, and they just speak up about it very fluently. But epis jealousy is all inside. They have taken it up. inside them, and the expression comes up in a very clumsy manner. They don't express so easily and so effectively as Lachesis does, but they constantly feel insecure about their partner. Epis women, they are constantly apprehensive that they may lose their husband to another woman, that he will have sexual experiences with other women of a similar intensity to which they share within the marriage. They have great difficulty in discussing such concerns, however. Epis individuals are closed, not because it is their nature to be so. Epis individuals are closed, not because it is their nature to be so, but because they do not know how to express themselves. They feel like crying all the time. Kent writes, the symptoms themselves are great sadness, constant tearfulness without any cause, weeping night and day, cannot sleep from tantalizing thoughts, worrying about everything, extreme irritability and borrows troubles. Woman urine, for instance, she cannot have a child and the ovaries are full of cysts. So this is the correlation of ovarian cysts. We have done PCOD quite many times and we have seen how cysts get affected by different types of emotions. Now in this one of the PPT, I was just studying Epis and I found this craving for milk. So again, it is related to nursing desire for. Epis is, they are good multitaskers. They feel overworked, very fast thinkers. So the movie where Priyanka Chopra was telling Ranveer Singh that I want to break up, I want to have a divorce, when they are going on a ship, and that was the time when they had all gathered to celebrate marriage anniversary of their parents, and she suddenly declares that, you know, I want to get divorced. So how is she? She's also shown a very fast thinker and a very successful businesswoman. If they feel betrayed, they will strike out. There's a strong sense of family, want to be in control and protect, as a bee want to protect her hive. Task oriented, aggressive if she is betrayed or crossed. So when there is a betrayal, please, please halt there and think before just jumping to hyoscyamus or rusclabra or any other remedy. So this is all about feeling of inadequacy, social inhibition, extreme sensitivity, cluster C personality, as written by Dr. Beena Das. And negative self-evaluations, avoidance of social interaction, despite a strong desire to be close to others. In Shrine's synthesis repertory, in Dreams, there is written by Dr. Kent, Dreams being a girl. So girl is someone that all women want to become again, where they feel that girl, you know, is protected. Girl is free to play without the burdens of life, without responsibility. They are just cheerful in their own natural ways. They have all the freedom to play along, to mingle, to eat, sleep, and do whatever they want to do. And that is what they dream about. In jealousy in women, again, Epis is mentioned single. Why? What is woman? Woman is who is matured. Woman is who is having a lot of responsibilities and who sees that kind of love being shared among other people, but she is not given, she is not understood, and she is deprived. And others are getting, but she does not speak about it. That is a woman who thinks 10 times, an ideal woman will think 10 times before speaking something which can hurt others. That is an ideal woman. And those kind of women who don't want to disturb others, who don't want others to know about their emotions, and they just harbor jealousy inside them. They think everyone around me is so happy. My friends are happy. My cousins are happy. They have got their parental support. They have got all the love and nourishment from their parents. But my parents have been so unavailable to me, even though I have parents, but they have never spent that quality time with me. And they have not stood for me whenever I went wrong in my life, or whenever there came a situation that they should have been there just to keep their hand on my shoulder and say, it's okay. They are not there. I have to do it by myself. So those women, and they get jealous about it, but then they harbor it inside, and then they have dreams of being a girl. So this is the cycle of Apis. It is in insecta, invertebrate, arthropods without backbone. You see, they don't have a backbone. They have to be the backbone of their own selves, of their family, of their loved ones, their children, or their siblings. They have to bring them up. So that is a kind of Apis personality. Hymenoptera, honeybee, poison of the apium virus. So Apis and Formica rufa come under this. Formica rufa is under study. You also study. Thank you so much. Do like, comment, and subscribe. And I just love this entire team of HHF. Thank you all for being there. These lovely memories with our masters will always be carried throughout our life. Love HHF. This love is energy, spiritual connection between all of us. It cannot be created nor destroyed. It will always be there. So gratitude to my masters, Dr. Narendra Gupta sir, Mohanty sir, and Rao sir, for being there and shaping us so well. These are my details. For my book, you can contact Dr. Sheetal Savan. It is for all the homeo lovers and especially the students of BHMS. Just take my words, all the students of BHMS, this book is a must for y'all because it contains step-by-step understanding of entering in any type of case. This is how Rao sir had taught us. Every method, the entire methodology of case taking is taken in this book. So do take it. Thank you so much. Do like, comment, and subscribe. Bye. Good night. Good night. Good morning. Good night for me for the day.